Welcome back to Resident Evil 18. Last time, I don't know what country you played, always, but you're going to play as Cuba. But guess what? Today we got kind of a surprise here, okay? We got a comment last time to host and invade USA and invade Europe. And let's see if we can do that in this video. So, what is our plan here? We want to go and get Haiti and Dominican Republic, which is going to give us at least 3 square cities that's going to help us create our tanks. And did you know that if you put a factory on a square city, you make 2,000 money in resources? Always put your factory. If you have the ability to put factories on square cities, put your factory on square cities. But you also have to consider the time. So if you're in the early game, you need to make like a lot of electronic factories, a lot of consumer factories. You need to do it in speed, and you don't want it like, because everybody's competing with you. You can just make them in the small cities, okay? If you have one big city like most countries, just go for the little cities just so you can get the boost and do it quickly. That's what I would recommend. If you don't want to do that, and like don't want to lose the benefits of having like 200,000, money for each factory in a square city, you can just do something else. So, you see, I'm invading right now Guinea, Sierra Leone, and Liberia. What is the big problem of these countries, and why I'm getting them, is that Sierra Leone has the titanium, Liberia has the iron, and Guinea has the aluminum, which will help me be more self-sufficient and make me not pay for trade. And those two countries are connected. Now, haha, I'm a bit debatable, but I did invade a European country, okay? I got Turkey. I think most of the lands were full, like you got, that was Albania and stuff. That's gonna be the European country that we have now. But the main problem is that I couldn't really get America. They were my ally. And the big thing, if you're playing as Cuba, it's very hard because America's always gonna kill you at the first thing. Like, the first thing I do, first movie is gonna do is just kill you, okay? Because you get too much influence in the Caribbean, and that's really gonna make his. He's gonna give him a lot of trouble. So we have to always ally him in the beginning. So, what else do we have now? So I saw England was fighting China, so I was like, okay, gotta help. This is unfair. You got China against England. Like, what is this? So I joined in the side of England. So what is the plan here, boys? What is the plan? What I'm trying to do? So I already have Turkey, and the main thing that I'm doing right now is economy. I should have developed more. I should have expanded more. I really did not do a good job on that. I should have went for Venezuela or Colombia, where they have a lot of population, and they could get on those population and give me some nice taxes, but not about that. But we really need now is just to close off the borders with Turkey, put some troops there, and also put on the coastline in case if he does naval invasions. But the main thing that I saw from China was that this guy, he is playing very, let's just say he's playing very safe, and he's letting himself build up and letting us build up. So I think letting him build up is much more worse. But you saw that in these wars, China is really, he's scorching, and then he's just putting troops over there behind the scorch. Understand? They don't want us to go in. And that's the big thing of scorch. If you scorch your land, it's very hard for troops to go. And it's just like, okay, you're just saying to the other country, hey, you're not passing through here, and I'm not passing through here. So it's like just like a, you know, a peace zone. No one's going there. No man's zone, you know? But he cannot scorch everywhere. That's for sure. Because scorching does decrease your stability because it increases unrest. So that's why we went for his capital in Beijing. We always want to reduce that stability. And you know, China, best way to destroy China is to break China. And that's the best way to destroy any big country. Go go in capital snipe and actually hold the capital, okay? Because if you hold it, they're having the negative effect. Or if they move their capital, that means they have to use a lot of political power, which is very good. That means they cannot do any more laws, any more policies. That means they can't maybe get more manpower or even change their ideology, which is very good for us. Now, you'll see the fighting. Mm-hmm.